Good morning. I'm out here at the Big Sandy Trailhead in the Wind Rivers, and as you can see, even on a Wednesday morning post Labor Day, this trailhead is absolutely packed. I'm a little surprised. I think this many people would be here, but I've been wanting to get out to the Wind Rivers for a long time, and I finally made a trip happen. So for the next 4 or 5 days, I'm planning on doing a 65-mile loop. Should be a ton of fun. Everything I've heard has made this range seem one of the most spectacular in the 48. So excited to get out there. Finally out on trail. It's different than I expected. I expected this whole, I don't know, to be way more rugged and less traffic, but like, you know, this is the most popular trailhead in the Winds, and even though it's not a national park or a state park, it's still super well known. It's just this trail is like, I mean, it's practically a walking trail. I don't mind it though. Isn't a good start to the morning, because it was sluggish. It was one of those mornings where I'm just trying to like figure out where everything goes, trying to put this there, where's that go, got to do this inefficiently, and it just takes forever. First view. Leaving this beautiful stream behind, and we're moving to the CDT. Woo! And going uphill now. I just almost walked right up on a moose. It was behind that bush. I wasn't paying attention. And now I don't know what to do. It bolted away when I got close, and then it just said, "The trail is mine." Step off.
Step off! Step off! Step off! Step off! Step off! Did I do what you say?
So it took a circuitous route around the trail, and we're good again. The moose, Mrs. Moose, really, that was her part of the trail. You know, I was not, I was not getting through there. I can't believe how much it's warmed up out here. I mean, when I got up around 7, the car thermometer said it was 28 degrees outside, and it definitely felt cold. Now by like, I mean, it's 9 o'clock, but by 8:30, down to shorts and just sun hoodie, no gloves. We got ourselves a view. This place is definitely starting to close up for the winter. All the grass at this elevation is pretty much brown. The only thing green left is like the lichen and like the tiniest of shrubs. So it's not the most stunning, I guess, but it's pretty cool to see the mountains closing up for winter, because that's new for me. Oh, found a lake. One of like 100 on this hike. So clear though, you can see the fish down there. So the trail isn't as isolated as I was kind of fearing after the morning. I've seen 2 people on the trail already, and there's a tent up here, up by the lake. So it's, yeah, it's definitely still hopping post Labor Day. Just people weren't getting started as early as me. They were driving up, like sane people. Okay, get to the north end of the lake, and yeah, all the people. You go like in 2 hours in the morning not seeing anyone, and then there's just like 8 people within a mile of each other.
So, yeah, definitely people out here. I think my guess is when I get north to a certain point, I won't see as many people. But we'll see. I could be very surprised.
Lunch thoughts. Wind Rivers, awesome. Just trailing along the CDT, along kind of the bench of the mountains, has me really anticipating heading up there tomorrow. They look super cool. I'm like, this is all really nice and cool. But like, you see something that's bigger and higher, and you know, just how it goes. But it's an easy trail right now. I like that for a day one. It's good.
So I'm stuck by this stream here. I don't really want to have to take off my shoes. It's a little chilly out. So I've been hunting down a place to cross. And I think I've narrowed it down to up here as a pretty prime spot. There's lots of rocks. I think it's an easy crossing. No taking off the shoes required. Just prime. Just more mileage. But mileage is goals. The more mileage, the better, right? 10-mile mark. Woo!
I'm not like technically above tree line because there's trees on the mountains, but like clearly I'm getting higher because I mean when you look at the view, there aren't really many trees around at this point. Pretty wide open. Pretty brown, pretty orange.
It's almost 5 o'clock now, and I'm definitely getting a little tuckered out here. Fortunately though, it's all this super steady downhill, and the country's so beautiful, like, just can keep puttering along, but I think we're nearing an end for the day. Just want to make sure I get past that 15-mile mark, because I know tomorrow is going to be harder than this one. And if I can cut out some extra miles, that would be prime. Because I think the 30-mile mark is a big low point. So it'd be nice if I could camp right around there and stay and keep a little warmer at night.
Around 5:15, calling it quits for the day. Yeah, it was a good day, good effort. Tent pitched up pretty nicely. I think that'll hold up well against the wind. And it's a small campsite, but I think the view is pretty awesome. Frankly, it might be a little close to the trail technically, but it's a good bit above the trail, and this trail is really, really empty. So, I think it's fine. I didn't want to figure out what was over there. I was just like, this is good. I know it's past 15 miles, and that's good enough for me.
Set up camp for the night. This is the view we're going with. It's pretty golden. Pretty golden. I like it. I like being elevated above everything, but... So today I think I made good progress, about just under 16 miles, I think is what I'm going with.
because I made it to the north tip of Raid Lake before I set up camp. Tomorrow's profile, definitely more elevation than today. Definitely higher, definitely colder. But it should have some spectacular views. And nothing too egregious, I think, elevation-wise. Should be able to handle everything fine. And the pack's getting lighter. One thing I'm thinking about, though, is like... Yeah, that's it. Morning number two, and it's a little hard to get out of the bag. It's so warm and cozy, and it's cold out, and the tents, the tents practically raining with all the frozen condensation. That's not all frozen. But as nights go, that was fair. I was so tired going into it, just from lack of sleep and regular life, that I slept pretty well, but it's still camping, and it's cold, so I'm constantly readjusting the quilt, waking up, getting too warm, too cold. Fair night. 5 out of 10.
Day number 2. Let's go. I love the way you sink in ice. You sink in ice. So, now that I'm out on trail, happy to report that nothing got into my food last night. Prime, I can survive and not die out here. Number two, kind of warmer last night than I was anticipating. There's definitely some frozen ice, frozen water here and there, but for the most part, it's fine. I'm just in my sun hoodie and pants right now. Temperatures aren't nearly as intense as I was expecting in the lowlands. We'll see as we get higher, but I'm not planning on camping super high. Yeah, and just a little tired. Definitely feeling some of the morning. Burning down the city right on me with you. Smoke in the sky. You tight because I love the way you synchronize. You synchronize. Let the moon crystallize. Don't think twice. Yeah. Made it to Sandpoint Lake. There are just so many lakes on this hike. Like really substantial big lakes that I feel like if it was in another part of the world, they'd be destination hikes themselves. But I'm starting to wake up now, starting to get a little warmer, feeling a little more energized. It might just be the downhill, honestly. Goodbye, CDT. Look at this valley! Woo! Getting closer to the mountains! Smoke in the sky and I'm holding you tight. Yeah, cause I love the way we synchronize. Looks like I'm just going cross country now. There was a cairn, and then there was another cairn, and it said don't go to the lake. And so I'm not going to the lake, I'm going cross country. I hope that doesn't mean that the trail's too rough when I start getting really high up. It's because that would suck.
Fortunately, lots of cairns. Oh, and a trail, I think.
Trail.
Perfect. Definitely picking up an intensity today.
What a spectacular place to eat lunch. Like, crystal clear water, huge, sharp, knife-edge peaks, and dead brown grass,
and wildfire smoke, you know? What more can you ask for?
But yeah, smoke's starting to blow in. Not great, but it's not the worst. The sky's still blue, so that's better than it has been sometimes this summer in different places. So what I've seen, I have to go up this hella steep pass with this backpack on.
I think if I just had my trail running pack on, I'd find that pass intimidating. But with a 20-30 pound pack on, whew, it's gonna be spicy. There is someone coming down it though. It's gonna be the first person that I've seen all day in, like, I don't know, last night at 7 o'clock. So quite a while.
Easy peasy.
Everywhere you go out here, it's just so beautiful. It's just continuous. Love it.
Yeah, I think this gives a good idea of what the wind's like.
Been back under the trees now for a little while, and it's kind of like a pleasant change. Like, I enjoyed seeing all the mountains, pretty majestic descent, and now, like,
you know,
you're back to seeing dry, stony lakes.
No, but in all seriousness, it's nice to get out of the wind for a bit and just cruise on some flatter ground and just see, like, rocks and trees, and I just love the combo. It's just aesthetic as hell. I went the wrong way. There's a... this is not it. Cross a pole. I think if I go farther up, though, the actual trail crossing is somewhere around there. Ay, ay, ay. This trail is getting increasingly harder to follow. I just spent probably 15, 20 minutes just like maybe according to the GPS on the trail, but not, definitely not. And just kept losing it and figuring my own way down a slope. Slow going. Which I don't like because I want to be done. I think I'm going to eat dinner soon and camp later. Because I'm getting hungry and prefer to just eat dinner.
Just took a nice dinner up here on this rock plateau right by a stream. Yeah, I ended up testing it out, eating dinner, not at camp. Fine, no issues, not even worth a thought. Get some energy. Don't have to worry about any sort of food smells at your camp. Not that I'm cooking, it's really a problem, but I don't know. Probably like a mile and a half to go. Around 6:47, should get to, I don't know, set up camp right before dark. Maybe we'll need the headlamp a little bit. I think it'll be fine. It's still drop dead gorgeous out here, but I'm pretty done for the day. I was looking at the cool view. Yeah, it's still gorgeous, but I'm done. I just want to find a campsite and be done. Walk through a bog. I've been having such trouble following the trail. I guess I'm just not observant enough, and I keep just dooting off and then getting stuck in just like awful trees and brush. So that's where we're at headspace wise. Trail, boom, there we are. That's where we're camping. not the most beautiful place in the world, considering all the beauty around me, but it's good enough. Just trying to find a flat spot that wasn't a bog, just causing a lot of stress. Let me look at the time, see the damage. Yeah, it's about 7:30, so it's about time to pack in for the day. We made it past the 30-mile mark, that's good. So probably got about 14 and a half on the day or something, maybe 15. Regardless, we're making the pace, so I'm happy about that. About 8:30 now, camped for night number two. Made camp really quick. Everything felt very efficient and good. I think the mistakes were not drying out my tent at lunchtime because the floor was wet. Fortunately, I had a towel and that dealt with most of it. And just honestly opening this up to the dry air, I think helped. Yeah, so I'm ready for bed. It was a good, eventful day. Happy with my camp, feels comfortable. I'm gonna wake up to it. It's snowing in here most likely. Yeah, good stuff.